Welcome to my channel, Sunshine Shoulders. I'm Calvin. Thank y'all so much for stopping by again. Our number one fear in the Philippines and how to conquer it. Let's have that conversation today. I get a lot of questions from people wanting to visit here, or relocate, or slow vacation in the Philippines. And it always centers around crime, and the cost of living, healthcare. But no one ever really asked about money. But no matter what anybody tells you, our number one fear over here is losing our life savings or running out of money. So this video is just going to give you some tips on how to hold on to your money or the mistakes that I've made and I've seen others make. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor or anything like that. This is just my boots on the ground experience, but let's get to it. This is just some things, some mistakes I've seen people make that you shouldn't make. Number 10, and these are in order, loan money. Don't loan money to anybody over here. If you can afford it, just go ahead and give it to them, because there's a good chance you're not going to get it back. And, you know, when you loans always make friends into enemies. Don't loan your money to people over here. Gamble. There's more and more ways to gamble in the Philippines. Some of the biggest casinos are opening up over here. Bingo. Cards. You want to see your hard-earned money slip through your hands, then gamble. If you want to. And remember, you don't know the language over here, so you don't even know if somebody may be cheating you, but the odds are against you winning when you gamble. Number 8, invest. I mean, you're over here to relax. You're retired. We're in the spending stage. If anybody comes up to you with some investments, Axie, you know, that's that cryptocurrency game, or any number of Ponzi schemes and network marketing, just simply say no. Now, this is when you can say no. But we're at the point where if we lose any money now, it's going to be hard to recoup it. We're in the spending stage. No investments. Stay away from investment. 7, don't flash your money. You know, people over here think we've got more money than we have anyway. You never know who's watching you, especially when you go to exchange money. Just simply put it in your pocket and go on about your business. Don't flash your money. Try to carry as little around with you as you possibly can. And I'm going to get back to that. But don't flash it. Showing out. Because some people do it. Trying to impress a woman or somebody over here. Number 6 is, don't waste it on meaningless things. ATM fees. We spend a whole lot of money on that. Cable TV, Netflix. Eating out all the time. Impulse buying. Try to stay away from that if you possibly can. You're going to be able to hold on to your hard-earned money, because that's our number one fear. I don't care what anybody tells you. It's getting cheated out of our money over here and losing our life savings. I just running out of money. So yeah, 6 is don't waste it on meaningless things. Number 5 is don't carry it around with you. Remember, I was just talking about that. No, don't flash it. Well, don't carry it around. Don't carry big wads of money around with you. You're in the Philippines. You shouldn't be carrying any more than 5, 6, 7,000 pesos, and that's a lot. I mean, unless you're going to make some type of major purchase or something, then have the people meet you at the bank. But certainly don't carry that money around with you. Certainly don't put it all in your wallet. You know, stretch, I mean, you know, separate it into different pockets. But don't carry that money around with you. Never tell anyone how much money you have. I mean, is that common sense right there? That's never going to turn out good, because now they're going to start figuring out how to separate you from your money. Or they'll start treating you different. Well, it's nobody's business. Don't tell anybody how much money you have. It's a big mistake we make. People will tell a woman when they're chatting online how much their pension is, how much they have in the 401. You think I'm joking? I'm not playing. There was a gentleman about 3 years ago, right when I started my channel, he said, Calvin, these women don't realize that I earn $2,000 a month and I've got $250,000 in my 401k. She said it wasn't enough. And I'm like, well, why are you even telling her that? I said, you know, the woman probably earns about $250 a month. Never tell anybody how much money you got, guys. That's not good. Remember, you want to be worth more alive than dead. This is just common sense stuff, but these are mistakes I see people make all the time, every single day. Number two, stay away from credit. This is mainly a cash society anyway. But we'll come over here, and remember, a lot of us are older, we're 60 and above, average expat 62, and we'll start getting credit for motorcycles, cars. Stay away from credit over here. If you don't have it by now, you don't need it. It's that simple. And I'm not telling you what to do with your money. I'm telling you how to hold on to more of it because that's what you fear the most. Getting stuck over here 8,000 miles away with no money. Because we're going to laugh at you. We're going to put you on YouTube. We're going to put you on Facebook. And then we'll more than likely ante up and send your butt back home. But stay away from credit. If you don't have it by now, you probably don't need it. And the last thing I'll talk about is don't allow a woman to manage your money. She's going to screw it up. This is the number one way that we end up losing our life savings and running out of money. Money equates to freedom around the world. It's no different over here in the Philippines. You always want to have that money. Now you got some options. You're going to be happier knowing, hey, if something happens, I still got that nest egg. But if you put it into the hands of a woman, remember self-preservation over here, ladies and gentlemen. It's the basic rule of life. Don't do more for somebody else than you're doing for yourself. She's not used to managing that kind of money. She's going to waste it. She's going to start spending it on shit that she ain't got no business spending it on just because it's there. You earned it. You manage it. If you want her to spend it, okay, but you manage it. You budget it out. You piecemeal it out because we came over here to relax. We don't want the stress. And the number one cause of stress is lack of money, no matter who you talk to. So thank y'all so much for stopping by. Just a quick video to help us hold on to what's important to us, our money. That's our number one fear over here. It's not crime. It's not getting sick. It's not the health care. It's not the woman running away. It's you losing your damn money or running out of money. So if you're in America, it's getting late. Before you let your head hit the pillow, please find somebody to help. If you don't want them late, grocery runs, beer runs. Yeah, weed runs. Weed is legal in a lot of places over there. Are you on second shift? Oh, you're on your lunch break. You see somebody out in the street, wherever you see them, buy them something to eat, buy them something to drink. Give them a few dollars if it's not going to put your life in jeopardy. If you're in the Philippines, it's early, about 8:30 a.m. Now, a day goes by if we don't help somebody. Today's not going to be any different. I'm going to help somebody. I don't know who. I don't know where. Because if I don't know anything else, I know this one thing for sure. We help other people. We help ourselves. Take care. Stay safe. Stay out of trouble. I'll see y'all next time.